Namaste students. So, we are in the 7th chapter, that is Statistical Quality Control. And in the last session, we have seen some kinds of problem where we are drawing the control limits. We are not going to draw charts over here, just we are drawing the control limits. Now, we move towards the next kind of problem. Now, read the problem here. That is the 7th problem. The estimates of 10 samples, estimates of 10 sample size, samples of size 4 each. Their samples are how many samples? 10 samples of size 4 each. Average and standard deviation of the process are known to be 35.5 and 80. Now, average and standard deviation, that is nothing but mean and standard deviation is given. Construct the X bar chart. Construct the X bar chart. Now, one easy method to identify whether standards are given or not given. In case of not given, they always give in the word problem because they won't mention whether it is this one or like this. They won't mention in the problem. So, if they do not mention any this kind of terms, then it is always standards are not given. If standards are given, if they do not mention them. If standards are given means, they will mention like this. Or else they will give like this. If it is the each other, or else they give like this. Most of the time they will mention. So then here they did not mention anything. And it is standards are not given. It is standards are given where they have given the standards. So here we need to take the given standards. Now, where they say us to draw the control chart, there usually you will get the problems like tables. If they do not mention table names, it means they have given the standards. If tables are given names, you have to find out. Sometimes you have to find out standards, sometimes they will mention in the problem. Now here, as I said, they do not give the term like X double bar or the term like the range, such kind of things they have not mentioned. So it is standards are given. So we need to go with the formulas of standards are given. Which standards are given? Here, the mean is given as 35.5 and standard deviation is given as 8. And see here, we require the constants from the statistical table. So, the 10 samples are nothing but what we say K. Here n is equal to 4. With the help of that size, we are finding out the value of constants. Now here we need to write the control limits for X bar chart. Control limits for X bar chart. Control limit for X bar chart. Now we will write the control limits, that is central line, that is nothing but X bar 1. Here X bar 1 is they have given as 35.5. That is the first average which they have given. Then if we see the lower control limit, the formula is X bar minus A into standard deviation. So here X bar is 35.5 minus value of A. We need to take it from the table that we know the, here we know the size as 4. Now take the statistical table, size 4 and value of A is 1.500. Value of A is 1.500. So this is 1.5 into standard deviation is nothing but, what is the standard deviation? It is 8. Now here 35.5 minus 1.5 into 8, we get the 12. So 35.5 minus 12, we get 23.5. So this is about lower control limit. This is the average for lower control limit. Now, taking for upper control limit, the same formula, that is x bar minus, that is k standard deviation, sorry, plus here 35.5 plus a, we have taken from the statistical table, 1.5 into a. Now 35.5 plus 1.5 into a, that is 12. So here we get 47.5. This is about upper control limits. Now we have drawn the averages, that is limits, control limits. Then this is the center line. Here lower control limits and upper control limits. What is the question? Consult the x bar chart. Consult the x bar chart. But here in this problem, we cannot conclude here whether production process is under control or what, because they have mentioned just 10 samples. Which are the 10 samples? What are the values they did not give? Just we can represent the table. You can see how we are writing the our concept chart, how we are constructing. Now, here, x axis and y axis we need to take. X and y axis, here x axis. What I have told along the x axis here, it is some group numbers. That is subgroup numbers. How many samples is there? 10 samples. So start from here, 0. So here 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. You have to take the scale here. So, and 10 samples. And this side we are representing the averages. Averages are nothing but the limits. Now, while plotting the y-axis, while writing the values on y-axis, we need to see that which is the highest value or which is the lowest value among these three. Among central line, lower control limit and upper control limit. Here upper control limit we have the value still 47, and lower control limit we can see there 20. So it should cover, our value should cover 23 and 47. So we can start from 20. We can start from here, we can start from 20, and we can go with the 20, 25, 30, 35, till 50 we can go, because we have the values of 47. Or else we can go 20, 30, 40, that also we can go, but we get very small values. And here we need to show incline, because we have not here the values between the gap between the first value 0 to first value and rest of the values are not equal. So we'll take 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, then 50. Now how to write the lines there? How to write the line? Now see there, center line. Center line where that is 35.5. From the straight one line, that is center line, 35.5. Center line 35.5. Then lower control limit, that is 23.5. On an average, it will come here 20. With the dotted line, we have to represent upper control limit, that is 23.5. Lower control line. Now upper control limit is 47.5. Wait, on an average it will come here 47.5. Upper control limit, that is 47.5. This, for this you, it is not necessary you have to see that it's one graph. You have to draw it on the graph. You can draw it on the notes book only. Even in the exam, it is, you can write on the plain paper only. And here it is upper control limit. So this is about representing the averages or control limits on the chart. Now if we get values, the table, if we get values, you have to plot. For first sample, what are the average of what are the defects you can find. You can represent if any of the points in the case come below this line, lower limit, control limit, then you have to conclude that production process is not under control. If all the points are come between these two lines, then production process is under control. So this is about construction of chart. Then next we will see the problems where we need to conclude the production process is under control or not. We will see another kind of problem, that is gate problem. The standards are known to be x bar dash mean that is given as 20 and standard deviation is 6. Construct x bar chart for the following. Sample size, there inside the bracket they have given sample size n is equal to 5. When we get sample size as 5, for that a value is 20. If you see the table also, there will be 1.84. This they have given in the already given in the problem. So here it is not necessary for us to see any problem values in the statistical table, and all the this one standards are also given clearly, that is x bar 1 and standards. Now here we will write the standards given. Standards given. Which standards given? That is mean as 20 and standard deviation as 6, and the constant a that they have given 1.342. Now we will write a construct x bar chart for the following. Now control limits. Control limits for x bar chart. For mean or x bar chart, we have to find. Now let the central line. Central line as mean, that is what value they have given, 20. This is the first average, that is central. Now lower control limit is equal to x bar minus a, that is constant value from the table, then standard deviation. So here mean is 20, a value less than 1.342 into standard deviation as, what is the standard deviation here? It is 6. Now 20 minus 1.342 into 6 we get as 8.052. So when we minus 8.052 from 20 we get 11.947 something we get. We can get it as 11.95. Now upper control limit. Upper control limit. Take the formula mean plus a into standard deviation. Mean is 20, mean is 20, plus a value is 1.342 into, what is the standard deviation? Standard deviation is there. Standard deviation is 6. That is 20 plus 1.342 into 6, that is 8.052. Now 20 plus 8.052 is nothing but 28.05. So this is upper control limit. So here we got the averages, that is central line, lower control limit and upper control limit. Now we'll draw the chart there. Now control chart for, you have to write control chart for mean. Control chart for mean. Now take here x and y axis. X and x and y axis. So how many sample numbers are there? Here, right here, sample numbers or subgroup numbers. sample number. Here write the averages. Averages. Now sample number is still 6. Now, see the sample image we have to represent. Before that, we have to draw three lines there. That is upper control limit, lower control limit and the center line. Now, see the values here. Here, highest value is 28 and lowest is 11. So, here we can start from, we need to plot the values and here we have to see this is the highest value. Here, highest value is here 24. But we have more than that, here it is 28. So we need to take the values till 28. So we can go from we can go from 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. We start from 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. We have taken the values 5, 10, 15, that is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Now, see the values. For sample number 1, the before that, sorry, we represent the central line. Central line is 20. Central line. Upper control limit, that is 28 points. Upper control limit. 28.0.5, that is upper control limit. Now lower control limit 11.9. Approximately it becomes 11.995, that is lower control limit. Now see the table here. For first sample, what is the sample mean? Sample mean is 90. First subgroup number, sample mean is 15. So approximately 19. Here it is. For second one, it is 24. Second one, it is 24. Third one, it is 22. Third one, it is 20. On an average, it becomes 22. Then fourth one, it is 16. Fourth one, 15 is here. And there it is 16. And fifth one there it is 18. Fifth one is 18. Then sixth one it is 15. Sixth one is 15. Now join this line. Join this. Now see, is there any points are below the lower control limit? No, we don't have any values below the lower control limit. And these all averages of these plotted points are within the central limits, within the limits of lower control limit and upper control limit. So here we can conclude in this kind of problem, your production process. Therefore, see this conclusion you have to give below the table. Therefore, production process. Process under control. Production process under control. Under statistical control. Production process is under statistical quality control. Production process is under control. This conclusion you have to give below the table. So this is about plotting the control chart. Then this will come for 5 minutes. One question will be there. Either question will be like, just you need to draw the control limits. Most of the time you have to draw only control limits. But sometimes it may come, then draw control chart. So first we need to find out the control limits. Then three limits we have to draw there. Then between that we have to draw the averages or lines in order to check whether any lines are below the center, lower control limit, or points are above the control limits. We'll move towards the third problem. Now see, read the problem. The values of sample mean and the ranges are for 10 samples of size 4 each. Here, of size 4 each and how many samples? 10 samples is given below. Construct control chart for mean and determine whether production processes can happen. Now, can you see any of the standards there? Did they give any of the standards? No. They just given there 10 samples they have given and they have told 10 samples and of size 4. 4 and 10 samples they have given. Here in this problem, we know only what is given here. We are given that n is equal to 4 size and 10 sample. This sample number. Number of samples of sample number, we say it as k is equal to 10. We know the values of k and n. Then, they have given the sample numbers. As I said, when sample mean and ranges are given, here values are not given. When values are not given means, we need to find out the values. So now, we need to see the tables of standards are not given. For mean chart, standards are not given means, what do we get here? X double bar will need to find out. What is the formula there when standards are not given? Now, we just write control limits. Control limits for X bar chart. X bar chart. As I said, standards are not given. Samples are given. We need to find out the standards. So, see the table of standards are not given. So, there central line is equal to X double bar and lower control limit is equal to X double bar then minus A2 and range bar and upper control limit is equal to X double bar plus A2 and range here. This is given, this is the table of standards are not given. Now, what we need to find out? This A2 we can get it from the table. A2 we can get it from the statistical table since we know the size, it is 4. Then, this range bar and X double bar we need to find out. Now, how to find out? What is the formula? X double bar is equal to sigma X bar divided by K and range, the average range is equal to sigma r divided by k. And here we know the value of k, it is 10. Value of k is 10 here. Then we need to find out sigma x bar. Mean, x bar is given, x bar is given. Now the sum of x bar, the total we need to find out. When we total these values, we get a sigma x bar as 300. Sigma x bar as 300. And when we add these ranges, sigma r is equal to, we get as 200. Now, total of mean column and total of ranges is 300 and 200. Now, take sigma x bar there, 300 is equal divided by 10, that is k, we get here 30. X double bar as 30. Now, range here 200 there, sigma r divided by 10, here we get 20. Now, we got the standards out of this sample, that is 30 and 20. Now write the control limits, that is X central line as, that is 30, central line is 30 there. Now, lower control limit. X double bar is 30 minus A2 obtained from the table. N is 4 here. Take the table there where N is 4 and value of A2 is 0.729. A2 value 0.729 into range we got as 20. It is 20. Now multiply 20 and 0.79, we get as 14.38. Now 30 minus 14.38, that is 15.4. 15.4 is nothing but what is that? That is lower control limit. Now upper control limit, take it x minus 0.729 into 20. Now 30 plus 82 into range, as I said, what do we get? 14.38. Now 30 plus 14.38, that is 44.58, that is upper control limit. Now represents the chart, control limit, actually control starts for V along the x axis and y axis. Now see the values, x axis, here it is, y axis, we represent here averages. Here we represent averages. Here what they have to do? Sample numbers. Sample numbers along the x axis. Then write sample. Okay, here averages. Now see the values here. Which is the highest value? Now see the sample mean. Because they have given constructor control chart for mean, so we need to see these two values. If they say constructor control chart for range, then we need to see this and this range is we need to see. Now see here, which is the highest value here? Highest value here is 45, and here it is 44, 15, and 30. So on an average, we need to draw around 50 or 47, 50. We need to draw. Now take the values. How will you take the values? We can start either from 10, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, or else we can go with 10, 15, 20, 25. Better we can take it from, we would see the values here. This is the lowest value here. Here 13 is there. So we need to start from, we take the value. Here, how many sample numbers? 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, here you start from 10. 10, 20, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Better we go 10, 15. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. We have taken values 50. Now see there, first one. Here you have to see mean table, because we need to construct a chart for mean. We need to construct a chart for mean. So we need to see the mean table. One, for first sample number, it is, sorry. Before that, we need to represent the central line and upper control limit and lower. Central line is 30, write the central line, that is 30, then lower control limit is 15.42 something, okay. 15.42, lower control limit, that is 15.42, next upper control limit 44. Upper control limit 44. Upper control limit, that is 44.5. Now represent the values. For first sample, it is 20. For first one, it is 20. Then for second one, 34. Second one it is, it will come as 30, 34, and third sample number 45, third sample number it is 45. Fourth sample number it is 39. Fourth sample number it is 49. Fourth sample number it is. Fourth one it is 39. And fifth one it is 23. Then sixth one 37. Sixth one 35 here it is 37. Okay. Seventh one 34. Seventh one just below the 34. And eighth one it is 13. Eighth one it is 13. Eighth one it is 13. And ninth one it is 29. Ninth one it is 25. Plus 29. And last 10th one it is 26. It is 25 here, 26. Now plot the, now join the line. This first one and where it is second one. Second one we got as 34. Second one over. Third one, fourth, fifth, seventh, eighth one, ninth one, tenth. Now, if you check here, one value is below the lower control limit. This particular value is below the lower control limit. Don't mark in your chart, no need to mark for your reference, I have marked it. Below the lower control limit. If you find any values below the lower control limit, then we need to conclude that production process is not under control. Production process is not under control. Production process is not under control. Here one value is above the upper control limit, that is fine. But if you find any values below the lower control limit, we need to conclude that production process is not under control. This is about conception of control chart where standards are not given. Where standards are not given, we need to find out the standards through the samples which they have given. Then we need to draw the limits for which chart they mentioned it. Then we need to plot particular chart. As I said,